afternoon. It is a Saturday afternoon chat. Kidman ends here. Kit's tired. He's sleeping. I walked in and he's just like, what the freak? I'm supposed to get the whole afternoon to sleep like I do Monday through Friday. I'm sorry, Kit. I'm very sorry. But yeah, so I don't have a show this week, but there's some news on the news front that I thought we should just talk about here for a little bit. Miranda Lambert and Blake Shelton, country music's young power couple, have since split up. And according to In Touch, she's pregnant and dumped. Who knows if that's true, but yeah, that's craziness. But I saw on TMZ and other networks that he was cheating on her, she cheated on him, so it's just like, if she is pregnant, who's the father? That's one to watch right there, I think. Either that or just fade out, but none of that's true, but yeah, so that's crazy. Hulk Hogan has been terminated from WWE and has erased him from the website. Good old Hulk Hogan has made racist comments about The Rock and black wrestlers in his sex tape, which is part of Hogan's $100 million invasion of privacy lawsuit against Gawker Media. So, yeah, he made some racial comments, and, yeah, WWE took him down, which is crazy. I mean, the only reason I'm talking about this is because it is the Hulk. Say, kid, it is the Hulk, and the Hulk is something else. WWE is committed to embracing and celebrating individuals from all backgrounds, as demonstrated by the diversity of our employees, performers, fans worldwide. Or we just don't want to get sued. Whichever. You believe what you want to believe. But, yeah. It's craziness. So there's that going on. And then the Honey Boo Boo news. We're just going to talk about a little bit of Honey Boo Boo news, you know? Honey Boo Boo resurfaces at the red carpet event. She looks so grown up. She does. Honey Boo Boo's getting old on us. And she doesn't look like crazy, like, you know, they kept saying about how she was becoming overweight and stuff. This was at the Love and Hip Hop Atlanta. She's only 9. I thought she was like 13 by now. She looks so grown up, as all smiles and a summery skirt and tube top. Her blonde curls were pulled back in braids. And again, the show was canceled last year after Mama June was accused of dating a sex offender. Can you believe that, Kit? I know, I thought really something would happen by now. But don't you worry, I will continue to check for you. But on the other news, Perez Hilton has finally covered for us. Here's what Honey Boo Boo's Mama June thinks of TLC finally canceling the Duggars. It might not be what you expect. Here comes Honey Boo Boo star Mama June and is in an awkward position now. On the one hand, she should be glad TLC finally canceled 19 Kids and Counting, which is what she wanted. On the other, it means she has to drop her threatened lawsuit, and the long consideration time the network gave the Duggars shows that there was a double standard for the highest rated show. So what does Mama June have to say about the 19 kids being canned? She actually thinks they're getting off light. According to the reality star, the family may be canceled, but they still get their own documentary special later this year. Truth. And she isn't cool with that, she said. I feel it will be another situation for them to get paid for doing something bad. That's actually a fair point. It's TLC's canceling 19 Kids and Counting now to later replace it with the Duggar specials every few months. Mama June thinks that the network should cut all ties with the family. What do you think? Now that's a conundrum right there because, yeah, I mean, they are going to still get money and paid, but did they do something wrong? I mean, come on, enough time has gone by now. The guy made a mistake. What can we say? I know, Kit. It's crazy. He made a mistake. You know, it's not socially acceptable mistake, but yeah. Why does Honey Boo Boo? We don't have Honey Boo Boo specials. Just like the Little People Big World, they make specials every couple months. Why can't we go back and revisit? just because Mama June had sexual relations with a sex offender, which again is in their own bedroom. As long as the sex offender's not out there near your pumpkin or any of the other kids doing anything funny, I don't see a problem with that. But who am I? And now we're just beating a dead horse because we've already talked about this months ago. But yeah. So there you have it. That's what I've got for you this week. A very exciting Saturday afternoon chat. I'll come back next week unless something crazy happens. I think I have another show to talk about. I actually have a couple on my list, so we can dive into another trash television show. Teen Mom 2 is up and roaring again, and holy cow, this week, and I'm telling you, everyone's like, why are you watching Teen Mom 2? That show's for like teenage girls. It is, but the only reason I watch it is for the freaking train wreck, and I'm fairly certain that MTV is adding the train wreck in. I mean, this week, every chick on there, which are now like 23, were fighting with their husbands. Yeah, I think they're all married now. They were, or one, Janelle soon get married. She got proposed to. They go to St. Thomas. They come back, and then there's a big fight. And in the previews, they show that like she sends them to jail for supposedly abusing her. Which, is that true? Who knows? And at the same time, she's trying to get her damn kid back. But this isn't going to look good to the court because she's not very stable. It's madness. So, yeah, so Teen Mom 2 is up and roaring again. So, if you are a teenage mother, young woman, or just a weird guy like me who likes to watch train wrecks happening on television, there you go. It's on MTV's on Thursday night at 10. Kids sleeping, so that means this video is time to be over. Until next week, enjoy the rest of your weekend. And if you coupon, I'll see you tomorrow. Until then, bye.
Well, thank you very much. You have a good evening.
You have a wonderful day. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Have a beautiful day.